Bioprinting is 3D printing with cells. So printing with a material that contains a cell population within it, and that material is conducive for the transport of nutrients and oxygen, everything to keep that cell population happy, healthy, and functional. Ideally, we would love to be able to print tissues, everything from skin, bone, cartilage, up to organs like kidney, liver, heart, and have those available for implantation. The integration of AI into bioprinting can have a dramatic difference, particularly in what we can print and the efficiency with which we can print it.
The ultimate goal here for bioprinting is something called in situ bioprinting. If someone comes in with, let's say, a bad burn, you could 3D print them new tissue to cover up the burn region that would then regrow into skin. In order to do that, you have to be able to print on the fly. And so we're trying to build AIs that allow you to put a bioink in a bioprinter, tune the parameters very rapidly, and then go and print something that could be used for a patient. But right now, there's a lot of different challenges there. One is, how quickly can we try different things for making complex tissues? There is a large number of parameters that you can test. If we eventually want to produce tissues that actually act like human tissues, then we need to be able to choose the best set of parameters every single time. Right now, people manually perform this task, which takes a really, really long time. And so we realized that AI could be applied to rapidly increase the speed at which we could do investigations. This is the BioAssembly Bot 400. In order to build any AI that performs well, you need a lot of data. We've been generating a large training data set to train our AI models. We're printing under various print conditions, for example, different printer pressures or temperatures, as well as different environmental conditions. All that we've input right now is just the concentration of the bioink that we're using to print today. This is our foundational bioink. It's made out of gelatin. It's a material that cells like to live in. For its first attempt at printing, the AI has selected the pressure of about 15 pounds per square inch at a temperature of 11.4 degrees Celsius and a speed of 15 millimeters per second. What we're looking for is essentially strands that are strong enough to bridge long gaps so that they can be weight-bearing, and then also strands that have fine resolution, meaning that they're pretty consistent along the length of the strand. The AI has determined what the print quality of this is, and so based on that information, it's going to then select another set of conditions to try for its next pass. We've been collecting data for about a year and a half, and I believe we have the largest data set that exists on print quality optimization at about 2,000 plus different prints.
In the next 5 to 10 years, I would love Ryan and his efforts to have significantly impacted our ability to rapidly, efficiently create bioprinted products that could be used in the world of biomedical research.